So I want to begin with CNN national security analyst Juliette Kayyem. She's a former official with the Department of Homeland Security and a Boston Globe columnist. Juliette, the president pretty strongly defended the FBI against criticism, not just from partisans, that there were some mistakes. Do you think he's going to have to dial that back in the coming weeks?
He might have to, and I have to say, he should probably not be speaking about this case anymore. It's an ongoing investigation. That's why I think it's so important that the DNI is now leading a review. We don't know yet either whether the FBI should have reviewed it more or whether their protocols are too weak given the kind of threat we have now. It's very likely the FBI followed protocols, but those protocols aren't going to catch the kind of threat we now face. The president probably shouldn't be talking about this anymore. It was right to send it over to the DNI, let them do review. James Clapper, long-term intelligence guy, support from both sides of the Hill. Let's not make this political, because as you've seen, it's becoming political now. There are questions for the FBI. Some people may know the answers, but we've seen this investigation is going in all sorts of directions, and I think we all look forward to the final review to see sort of how did those pieces put together, and as importantly, what changes should be made to the protocols or omissions done by the FBI.
Ambassador Thomas McNamara, who used to be in charge of the information sharing job, the guy in charge of making sure all the agencies were working together, he was on the show yesterday. He said the FBI is still not sharing enough information. He expressed concerns about the fact that the FBI and the CIA were both contacted by the successor organization to the KGB, the FSB, and no red flags went off. You must share some of those concerns.
Yes, well, I think one of the concerns is, well, why didn't the state and locals know? I mean, part of the JTTF, the Joint Terrorism Task Force structure, is the assumption that because we live here, Bostonians live here, we ought to know, even if the information isn't enough to make the FBI or the CIA worry, right? The second issue or question that has to be answered is, why aren't these pings, whether it's from the CIA or DHS, requiring a new review? And it may very well be that there's so many of them, or there's that the Russians were not giving us more information, which I think is a key point right now.
Right.
And so that's why you want a review taken out of the White House and taken out of sort of White House spokespeople and putting it in with someone who is not known as a partisan, Clapper, who's just overseeing the intelligence agencies. And I think that's going to be important.
And the president's remarks about the Russians were pointed, talking about a Cold War mentality and talking about praising them for their cooperation after, not the cooperation before, Julia.